My name is Nils Thürey. Since October 2013, I am a professor for games engineering here at the Technical University of Munich. And my research area are fluids. For example, the water that I have in my glass here is a typical fluid, or the air around me, although you can't see it. And the complexity here is really that if I move my hand through the air, there is some motion of the air behind it. And these motions break down into smaller and smaller swirly motions, vortices as they're called. And all these vortices interact very tightly in a very complicated manner to form the final motion of the air in this case. It's really important to actually capture all these effects accurately. Traditional application are, for example, to simulate the flow around an airfoil to make a plane fly better or with less fuel, or by now also to simulate blood flows in our bodies, for example. And to get a good prediction of what the reality is doing, we typically need very complicated models and a lot of computational power to resolve these effects accurately enough. By now, actually, they're also widely used in computer graphics, for example, for feature films and movies. Many explosions that you see by now in the cinema are actually coming out of the computer because it's simply too dangerous to do this in reality or too expensive. The method that we proposed recently tackles this problem from a slightly different perspective. So instead of purely relying on simulations, we also use video data that is actually analyzed in combination with the simulations to get a better prediction of what is really happening. The advantage is that videos, for example, of a smoke cloud are relatively easy to capture, and they directly capture all the complex effects such as turbulence or wall interactions that are otherwise very difficult to model and to calculate. Not too far away, I believe, is to use this data for example, special effects to get more realistic or faster effects in computer games and movies. But I think in the long run, it's also a very interesting direction to actually use these techniques in combination with medical data. We are using a lot of techniques, for example, MRI and CT scans, to capture how the blood is flowing in our bodies. And combining it with simulations, I think, could give doctors much more knowledge about what is really happening with these flows in our bodies.